in previous recessions, a rebound in the hiring of temporary workers was a sign that full-time jobs are right around the corner. Will that be the case after this recession? Allison Kosick is in New York with more, and the answer, for the sake of a lot of people watching us, needs to be yes to that question.
Yeah, but it's definitely not a sure thing, Tony. You know that temp job is going to wind up leading to a full-time one. But I'll tell you what, one thing is certain. Temporary employment is on the rise. In fact, the economy has added temp workers for 4 straight months. And if you talk about people in jobs, that's almost 250,000 temps added since September. Now, in the past, that's led to a resurgence in full-time workers. In many cases, employers would hire temp workers, and then a few months later, the economy would recover, and those temps would become full-time employees. But we've yet to see the recent surge in temp workers.
Get something done on health care. So if people out there looking for a job are taking this temp work, and then 3 months later they have to find another temp job, are they better off holding off for the full-time gig, you know, of course, if they can afford to do that?
Well, let's point to a study. MIT is doing this study. It's been ongoing since 2005 of low-skilled workers in Detroit, and it's continually found that most temp work is exactly that. It's temporary. The latest revision of the study found that worker in the workplace, you do have a chance of fostering that long-term relationship, Tony.
Okay, Allison, appreciate it. Thank you. Let's do this.
Sure.
Let's get you caught up on our top stories now. U.S. officials say the Taliban's top military leader has